Good evening and welcome to our evening prayer. I've worn the canon's cotta this evening with its red trimming. It just seems appropriate to underline the red of today, St. Bartholomew, the red of an apostle, the red of one, a foundation of the faith of the church. It's a wonderful feast day. We reflected this morning how he was recognized by the Lord as incapable of deceit, a man of great honesty and great integrity. He professes his faith in the Lord. And it's presumably that must have been that combination of gifts, of that honesty and of that faith, which made him such a witness to the gospel as one of the apostles. We'll pray later for those who continue to witness, pray particularly for those who volunteer as catechists and in the various programs in the parish. We'll pray for those who have had the faith handed on to them, that they may deepen that gift and in their turn give it to others. It's part of that handing on from God to us, to each other, which is very much at the heart of the Angelus prayer with which we begin. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, and she conceived of the Holy Spirit. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it done unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt amongst us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ thy Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, come to our aid. O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Alleluia. Now let the heavens with joy resound, and earth the chant re-echo round. Nor heaven nor earth too high can raise the great apostles' glorious praise. Theirs was the steadfast faith of saints, the unconquered hope that never faints, the perfect love of Christ to know that lays the praise of this world low. In them the Father's glory shone, in them the Spirit's will was done. The Son's glad praise to them is given, with joy resound the courts of heaven. To thee, Redeemer, now we cry, that with this glorious band on high, through endless ages by thy grace, thy servants also may have place. You are the men who have stood faithfully by me in my trials. I trusted even when I said, I am sorely afflicted, and when I said in my alarm, no man can be trusted. How can I repay the Lord for his goodness to me? The cup of salvation I will raise, I will call on the Lord's name. My vows to the Lord I will fulfill before all his people. O precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful. Your servant, Lord, your servant am I. You have loosened my bonds. The thanksgiving sacrifice I make, I will call on the Lord's name. My vows to the Lord I will fulfill before all his people, in the courts of the house of the Lord, in your midst, O Jerusalem. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. You are the men who stood faithfully by me in my trials. I am here among you as one who serves. When the Lord delivered Zion from bondage, it seemed like a dream. Then was our mouth filled with laughter, on our lips there were songs. The heathens themselves said, what marvels the Lord worked for them. What marvels the Lord worked for us, indeed we were glad. Deliver us, O Lord, from our bondage as streams in dry land. Those who are sowing in tears will sing when they reap. They go out full of tears, carrying seed for the sowing. They come back full of song, carrying their sheaves. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I am here among you as one who serves. I shall not call you servants anymore. I call you friends, because I have made known to you everything I learned from my Father. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places. He chose us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and blameless before him. He destined us in love to be his sons through Jesus Christ, according to the purpose of his will, to the praise of his glorious grace, which he freely bestowed on us in the Beloved. In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses, according to the riches of his grace, which he lavished upon us. He has made known to us in all wisdom and insight the mystery of his will, according to his purpose, which he set forth in Christ. His purpose he set forth in Christ as a plan for the fullness of time, to unite all things in him, things in heaven and things on earth. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. I shall not call you servants anymore. I call you friends, because I have made known to you everything I learned from my Father. From the letter to the Ephesians. To some, his gift was that they should be apostles, to some, prophets, to some, evangelists, to some, pastors and teachers, so that the saints together make up a unity in the work of service, building up the body of Christ. In this way, we are all come to unity in our faith and in our knowledge of the Son of God, until we all become the perfect man, fully mature with the fullness of Christ himself. The word of the Lord. Tell of the glory of the Lord, announce it among the nations. Speak of his wonderful deeds to all the peoples. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. When all is made new, and the Son of Man sits on his throne of glory, you will sit on 12 thrones to judge the 12 tribes of Israel. My soul glorifies the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Saviour. He looks on his servant in her lowliness. Henceforth all ages will call me blessed. The Almighty works marvels for me. Holy his name. His mercy is from age to age on those who fear him. He puts forth his arm in strength and scatters the proud-hearted. He casts the mighty from their thrones and raises the lowly. He fills the starving with good things, sends the rich away empty. He protects Israel, his servant, remembering his mercy, the mercy promised to our fathers, to Abraham and his sons forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. When all is made new, and the Son of Man sits on his throne of glory, you will sit on 12 thrones to judge the 12 tribes of Israel. Since we are all part of a building that has the apostles for its foundations, let us pray to the Father for his holy people. Father, when your Son rose from the dead, you showed him first to the apostles. Let us make him known, near and far. You sent your Son into the world to proclaim the good news to the poor. Grant that we may bring his gospel into the darkness of others' lives. You sent your Son to plant in hearts the seed of imperishable life. May we labor to sow his word and reap a harvest of joy. You sent your Son to reconcile the world with yourself by the shedding of his blood. Let us become his fellow workers in restoring all to your friendship. You placed your Son at your own right hand in heaven. Receive the dead into the happiness of your kingdom. Recalling that gospel, how Philip brought Nathanael Bartholomew to the Lord, and how the heathen Bartholomew then continued that witness. We pray in thanksgiving for those who brought this year's RCI candidates to the Lord. We pray that they may continue to deepen their faith, and indeed now to share it with joy. We pray for all those who may hear for that word of God. We pray that they too may find their way to the Lord. We pray for all the families preparing for baptism, for First Communion, and for confirmation. Ingrid asks that we might pray and light candles for Nick, Thelma's son-in-law, and Joshua, her grandson. And Nick has a serious infection in his hand. He underwent surgery today. Joshua is at home, but still doing tests to find out what is wrong with him. We light a candle for Ursula Brennan, keeping her and Rachel and the whole family very much in our prayers. We join with Elizabeth in thanking God for the speedy recovery of Grace from a fever. We pray for Roderick, who's been readmitted to hospital with a stroke. We pray for Keith, a cancer survivor who needs an operation, but it's complicated by his heart condition. We pray for Elizabeth's husband. We pray with Joe, who asks that we include Gerald and Bernie Smith in the evening prayer, praying for their well-being. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Let us pray. Almighty Lord and Father, strengthen us in that faith with which St. Bartholomew gave himself wholeheartedly to Christ your Son. Grant, as his intercession, that your Church may become the sacrament of salvation for all the nations of the earth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. And the Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, Vita Dulcedo, Espes Nostra Salve. A te comanus, exules filii Eve, a te suspiramus, gementes et flentes, in hac lacrimarum vale. Ea rego, advocata nostra, illos tuos, misericordes loculos, ad nos converte. Et Iesum, benedictum fruntum ventris tui, nobis post hoc exilium ostende. O clemens, O pia, O dulcis Virgo Maria. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.